Well, good morning to our YouTube viewers and our website and app viewers here on WGN. Yes, this is that annual demonstration. It's exactly what you think is about to happen. You can see back there the wooden mock-up of what might be a shed or a garage, perhaps a porch overhang, and some fire officials on scene. So this is Chicago Fire Department alongside the Illinois Fire Marshal, and they are doing their annual Turkey Fryer Fire Demonstration. The worst that can happen when you deep fry a turkey with improper, unsafe techniques. If you haven't seen this one before, it's an impressive sight, and it's one of those things that I try to balance the seriousness of the situation. They are talking about something that happens regularly every year that can lead to injury, if not death, and certainly a whole host of damage because of how quickly a grease fire can spread from a deep fried turkey. So balance that with the fact that this is a controlled setting with trained professionals, and I'm a former Boy Scout. And so there's just a little bit of excitement in watching something like that with the amount of flame, et cetera. So balancing those two factors, if you will. But nonetheless, we're gonna see this demonstration that CFD puts on every single year. For those that haven't seen it, here's your first time. For those that have seen it in the past, like myself, always entertaining to watch, certainly engaging to watch. And then I also expect some tips and techniques for those that are interested in deep frying a turkey for Thanksgiving or any other time that they should be putting out here. So we were told the press conference, the demonstration would start around 9 a.m. Up to this point, there's been a couple of people to walk up to the microphone and do an audio check. We can see the demonstration site is set up in the background there. Again, the mock-up shed / garage with a fryer loaded in. So at this point, we are just waiting for the event to start. I'm going to go back to our standby screen here, but if you are interested in watching this right along with me, you're in the right place. Just stay tuned to this live stream as we expect the event to begin really any moment.
Okay, we all set? Phenomenal. So thank you so very much for coming to the Quinn Fire Academy for our annual Turkey Fryer demonstration. We are honored today to have you. So I am going to be your MC, and just to give you a little bit of a run of the show how we'll do this, we have two guest speakers that we're going to have come up and talk with you, our fire commissioner, our state fire marshal, and then we'll have you guys relocate to get a better advantage so you can see exactly what's going to happen, and I'll give you a description or a run-by play, so to speak, of what exactly is occurring there and some of the safety tips regarding this. So it is my distinct pleasure to invite our fire commissioner, Annette Nanceholt.
Thank you, Chief Schroeder. Good morning, and thank you for joining us today for this important holiday safety message. I want to thank our partners at Jewel and Home Depot for their continued support with the Chicago Fire Department. Their generous donations allow us the chance to put on these safety demonstrations. Thanksgiving has always been a time for family, friends, and holiday traditions. It's also a good time to share stories and good cheer. There is no bigger part to the Thanksgiving meal than the turkey and how it's prepared. Deep-fried turkeys have become a yearly tradition for many families. We are here today to discuss what steps need to be taken to ensure a safe outcome when frying those turkeys, and always remember fire safety first. While deep frying a turkey may add irresistible flavor, we all like a deep fried turkey, and juiciness to your Thanksgiving meal, there is also the potential for fire and serious injury, and we see that year after year. That is why some organizations such as Underwriters Laboratories and the National Fire Protection Association caution against using deep fryers. But if you must, and you feel your Thanksgiving dinner won't be the same without a fried turkey, then there are some precautions to protect you. I am sure everyone has their own special recipe. Well, I have one as well, and it's called the safety recipe, which is most important. Please wear protective gear in case oil splatters. Deep fry in an open outdoor area away from homes, porches, and garages, especially overhangs, on a solid, flat surface. Very important. Next, remember that oil and water, liquid or frozen, don't mix. Water causes hot oil to bubble and spill over, which can quickly result in a fire. That means you never put a frozen turkey into boiling grease. Let me repeat that. You never put a frozen turkey into boiling grease. Also, have an appropriate fire extinguisher that is easily accessible. If the grease catches on fire, stay calm and use your fire extinguisher. And remember, never throw water on an oil fire. If it gets out of control, please call 911. We'd be more than happy to come and help you. Be sure to keep bystanders to a minimum while you work your magic, and never let children or pets anywhere close to the turkey fryer. If we all abide by these safety steps and follow our recipe for safety, we can experience a delicious yet safe Thanksgiving holiday. Thank you and happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you, Fire Commissioner Nance Holt. Now it is my pleasure to call our acting State Fire Marshal, Dale Simpson.
Again, I'm Acting Fire Marshal Dale Simpson. I want to thank the Chicago Fire Department for hosting this event today and providing this information. Thanksgiving is the leading day for home fires involving cooking equipment, with four times the average number occurring. Ranges and cooktops account for almost three out of every five home fires, reported involving cooking, with ovens accounting for 13% of those fires. Cooking causes half of all reported home fires, more than two of every five home fire injuries, and is the second leading cause of home fire deaths. According to the U.S. Fire Administration, each year from 2017 to 2019, an estimated average of 166,000 home fires per year involving cooking equipment, with 2,300 residential building fires reported to fire departments on Thanksgiving Day alone. These fires cost an estimated annual average of five deaths, 25 injuries, and over $26 million in property loss. The OSFM encourages everyone to check that all cooking equipment is working properly and call a professional to fix them if needed. Also, before warming up the oven, make sure there are no items left inside. Many times a pan with a spatula is left in there as the heat up starts, and that's going to ruin your day. Never leave food that you're frying, boiling, or grilling unattended. If you leave the kitchen even for a short time, turn off the stove. Create a kid-free zone of at least 3 feet around the stove or anywhere you're preparing hot food or hot drinks. Set a timer to remind yourself when to pull items out of the oven. And if you're leaving the room and you don't turn off the stove, carry the timer with you. If there's a fire in the oven, keep the door shut and turn off the heat. And if you have any doubt about fighting a small fire in the kitchen or anywhere, just get out of the house. Some additional turkey fryer safety points. Use the turkey fryer outdoors only. Use long cooking gloves that protect the hands and the arms when you handle the pot. Make sure the turkey is completely thawed and thoroughly dry before frying. Make sure not to overfill the oil in your fryer. To determine how much oil to use, place the turkey in the pot you plan to use and fill with water to the level to adequately cover the turkey, and then mark this level. Remove the turkey, pour out the water, and make sure to dry out the pot and dry the turkey thoroughly. This will help determine how much oil is needed without causing oil to spill when you're ready to fry, which could lead to a fire, as you're soon to see here today. If the turkey fryer boils over and starts a fire, evacuate the area. And as said, if a fire occurs at any time, call 911 or your emergency number from outside the home and stay away from the fire. By following a few simple fire safety tips, your holiday will be enjoyable and free from a fire-related incident. Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you, Chief Simpson. I'd like to thank a few others that are here today that have joined the commissioner and the state fire marshal. Our director of the Quinn Fire Academy, Chief Stephen Clay, thank you so much. Commander Tim Northcross, executive assistant for the fire commissioner. And our chief of Office of Fire Investigation, Chief Ryan Rivera. So thank you for joining us today. So now we'll allow you to relocate over. Give you a description of what you're going to see and what exactly is happening at that time.
So right here, I need you behind this light. I am muted. There we go. So while they're moving, I figured I could rehash some of those tips because, yes, we have the most interesting part coming up, but obviously the main purpose of this entire thing was for those that are interested in deep frying to let them know what they need to do in order to stay safe. So there's the deep fryer in the setup. They're getting that prepared. The key things here to be safe while deep frying a turkey is wear protective gear. A specific item mentioned was gloves long enough to cover the arm, but overall it was noted to protect yourself from oil splatter. So really trying to cover any exposed skin just in case. Have it, the fryer that is, away from buildings on a solid flat surface, and most notably, not under anything. Certainly, depending on the weather, it would be tempting to do a deep fry, say, on the porch with a nice overhang there. Well, that wood above with the heat and the splatter and the fire that could go up, that's your reason not to do that, as we're about to see. Frozen and hot oil never mix, so never put a frozen turkey into boiling grease. That was probably the number one tip of all of this, because that is the primary cause of most of these fires, is water going into the grease, especially frozen, and then getting turned into gas or steam, and that's what actually launches the grease. And then when that grease hits the flame underneath, that's what has it catch fire. So we're about to see that firsthand here, though. Ensure the turkey fully thawed and thoroughly dried. And so a key part there is, frozen can be bad, but even a wet turkey or not fully thawed, something that has it. It looks like they're getting ready, so I don't want to miss this. So they are preparing to do this demonstration. I'm going to put this back up full screen, and then I'll come back with the rest of those safety tips that we were given as it relates to deep frying turkey. It's kind of hard to hear in the background there, but it does sound like the public information officer, or at least the person that was hosting the press conference, is describing to our photographers what is about to happen as they lower the frozen turkey. Steam already coming out of the pot. There goes the bubbling. You can see little bits of flame as the grease hits the burner. I'm not going to lie. I've seen this type of demonstration happen many times over the years being in this business, and it's happened more quickly than this. So I hope we're not catching a dud of a demo. But certainly something to be aware of if you've never deep fried a turkey is that it can happen very fast if you are putting a frozen bird into a fully boiling pot of grease. I'm really not sure if this is going to catch fire. As I was saying, kind of off screen, if you will, that I've watched this kind of demo happen multiple times over the years, and usually it's pretty instantaneous. That initial drop, that initial bubble, what we've started to see, and then the grease catches fire from the burner and just ignites up the pot, starts to ignite the area around it, and at this point, it's not looking like a successful demo. So we're going to keep watching this. But while we watch this, in case something else happens with this frozen bird in fryer oil, I will go through those tips. Again, the whole purpose of this demonstration is for anybody out there that is going to or thinking about deep frying a turkey for any meal, especially the holiday meal coming up next week. These are the things to keep in mind. One, protective gear to keep yourself safe from any oil splatter, especially if it's hot oil. It's going to burn you. Two, do so that the frying away from buildings on a flat and solid surface, specifically not underneath anything. And that's usually where these fires occur, is when we have some kind of bad weather event during the time that someone wants to be deep frying a turkey. So they go, oh, I'll just do it on the porch with the overhang. Okay, that is your recipe for disaster. Frozen and hot oil never mix. They attempted to demo that. I'm not there. I don't know the details. You know, was the bird not quite frozen? Was the oil not quite hot enough for this demonstration purposes? Was there not enough oil in it? Maybe they're going to try it again. It's starting to look kind of cooked, actually. But putting the frozen turkey, it's that water, it's the frozen part of the turkey into the boiling grease is what results in the bubbling, in the steam, in the grease coming out of the pot and ultimately catching fire. So along those lines, ensure that the turkey is fully thawed and thoroughly dry. One tip, this was a really good one that the state fire marshal, the acting state fire marshal said, was to actually do a check before doing the frying part. So he said to put your turkey into the pot, add water up to the level, the maximum level that you want the grease to be, so it's fully covered the bird. You don't need it way above it, but just covered it enough. Then take the turkey out and mark the line of where that water's at. That is how much grease, how much oil you need. So then you empty the pot, thoroughly dry it, because again, you don't want the water in there. And that line is what you use to add the oil to the fryer. Have an appropriate fire extinguisher nearby. So this is an important one. If you've never experienced a grease fire, which in my little pre-stream, before we went live on Facebook anyway, I noted that I enjoy watching these demonstrations because as a former Boy Scout, not just as a person or a guy, which that's a fair reason as well, but as a former Boy Scout, we did a lot of things with fire and fire training and safety and whatnot, and actually did cool things with firefighters, but I digress. I've actually experienced a grease fire at a campground and someone throwing water on it. So water does not put out the fire. Oil floats on water or keeps separate from water. So the water simply moves that oil in the direction the water is going, and thus the fire with it. So this person threw water on it, and the fire spread out. Fortunately, it was a campground, so it was on the ground, but nonetheless, all of us were like, oh my gosh. So an appropriate fire extinguisher is one that is designed for oil or grease fires. If grease catches fire, stay calm. Use the fire extinguisher. Never put water on it. I wrote the tip down, but obviously it's everything I just said. Call 911 if it's out of control. Keep pets and children away. And also accept help. Have someone there that can assist you if need be.
And well, the second bird has volunteered to show us how it's done.
The second bird has volunteered, is what he said. So it seems that they're trying this again, that they appear to have another frozen turkey.
I caught it.
Yep, okay. So they're going to try this again. Maybe we'll still get the flames from this annual demo. Accept help. Those were all the tips I had related to a frozen turkey and fire disaster. The state marshal gave out another good host of tips. I'm actually going to write up a little story. It's linked in the Facebook and YouTube description for the video. But he gave a lot of tips as it relates to just cooking indoors, because not everyone is going to deep fry a turkey, but most households will have some kind of cooking going on. Among the things that I caught there was checking the oven for items before turning it on. I know a lot of people out there, I certainly grew up in a house, use the oven as another storage location for excess pans. So checking that. Make a kid-free zone around the cooking area. Set timers, so that way, especially if it's a longer duration cooking event, you don't just forget about it and ultimately have something burn, if not catch flame. And then specific to an oven, if there is something that does catch fire, State Marshal said, do not open the oven. Keep it closed, turn off the oven, turn off the heat to it, watch it, and certainly if there's a greater concern, call 911. And the commissioner for the Chicago Fire Department had said they will happily come and assist. It is their job to put out any fires that occur as a result of cooking. So the reason you don't open that oven, just in case anyone out there was wondering, I mean, if you did and had a fire extinguisher, that's one thing, but opening it feeds it. It allows more air and more oxygen, which is required for burning, to get into that oven. And so that is the reason that you keep it closed. Ultimately, it would, especially if you turn it off and the fan's not running, it might just put itself out by burning up all the oxygen inside the oven. So those are all the tips that I garnered out of the talking portion of this before we got to the demonstration. They have queued up a second bird here, so we're hoping to see this demonstration and what can happen should you indeed put a frozen turkey into a pot of boiling oil. My guess is that the oil wasn't quite up to temperature. Because even if it's not a fully frozen turkey, a partially frozen turkey, a wet turkey, enough water, ice or otherwise, will cause that boil over of grease, and typically, again, the ones I've watched catches fire very quick. So I don't think it was hot enough. I also think maybe their flame may not have been high enough. So we'll see. They're working on it. Hop over to Facebook.
Here we go. What's the time now? What's the time?
Get it up to about 700. Send it to the seal.
That's what I was noting about the tip from the acting state fire marshal in being able to do like a test measurement with your turkey and your water and your pot beforehand. Flour on a grease fire, certainly in an extreme emergency, a dry, powdery substance, ultimately to try and choke out the fuel of the flame and prevent it from garnering more fuel, oxygen, other items, grease in this case, not a bad tip, but fire extinguisher is certainly the way to go. Someone saying they're purposely trying to start a fire now. Yes, in fact, the whole point of this demonstration was them purposely trying to start a fire. So those are some of the comments that I'm seeing here on YouTube. Looks like...
We're going to try it again.
Try it again. Checking it. All right. Put this up full. See if they can pull it off in a second. Called it a volunteer. The turkey, that is. Big drop. Definitely don't drop your frozen turkey from 2 feet above. There, so the boiling part, I mean, that's more typical than a 2 foot drop into a bucket. I'm not gonna lie, that's a bit of a dud of a demo. But the tips, that's the important part, right? The tips that they put out there, because these things do happen, especially in uncontrolled environments. So keep that in mind. And I'm gonna take the tips that they gave us here at this press conference, put them in the story. So whether you need to re-reference them or you need to share them with somebody, they will be there for you on WGNTV.com. All right, there are multiple other live streams taking place today here at WGN News Now. Next up at 10 o'clock, two of them. In fact, those that wish to watch Chicago City Council, that's kicking off around 10. And then there is also an Illinois Department of Transportation press conference, a couple days late on this one, but timely nonetheless, about being prepared for winter weather. And then starting at noon today, we've been following this one for quite a while. It is the final day of the Waukesha Holiday Parade trial up in Waukesha. So the trial concluded with 76 counts of conviction. And today is the second of 2 days of the sentencing hearing. We are expecting to hear from the defendant himself as well as some family before the judge then today gives the final sentencing. And he is facing 6 mandatory life sentences and nearly 900 years worth of possible other prison time as a result of those convictions. So that all taking place today. And then, of course, as news breaks, we'll have it for you here on WGN News Now. Always your latest headlines on WGNTV.com. Until those next live streams, I'm Chip Brewster. Have a good rest of your day, everybody.